Hey guys, so in this video we are going to talk about databases and database queries. So let's get into it. So the other day I was looking through some code of my project, and I noticed that we had a piece of, like, basically a database query that did something very interesting. Now, it kind of made me think about queries and a few thoughts I have on this, and some stuff that I see more or less, I see it sometimes, and I wanted to touch on it a little bit. There's this discussion that arises often, at least whenever I ask like a bunch of developers how to do something, everybody has a little bit of a different opinion on this topic, and that is where you put your filtering logic when you query a database. Now, most developers will say that you should put it in your query. In other words, you should not do your filtering logic in memory. You should allow the database to do this. And for the most part, that would say that that's a very accurate statement. I mean, the database is designed to do this, so you should absolutely favor doing that. But I've also found that there are situations where this is sometimes not, at least, I don't know if I would go as far as to say that it's not true. It's rather that I see people make an exception to this rule. And there's usually three situations where this happens, and I'll walk you through them. So for the juniors out there, what usually happens when you query a database is that you create a query of some sort, and you basically, like, you can create some indexes or something to make it more performant. And say a common query is, give me all the users, or give me a user with this ID, or give me users or products that fall into this category or were created at this time, etc., etc. Now, this is a very simple query, and you should always, like, if it's such a simple query, ideally you should favor allowing the database to do this for you. You shouldn't, like, some juniors who are not so comfortable in their role as a software developer, they will do something like, say that you wanted to get all of the products that were created on a certain day. Then they would read in all of the products in the database and do a for loop or something like that and just iterate through it. Don't do that. It is okay at small scale to do this, because there's no real harm in doing so. Because you're dealing with so small amounts of data, most likely. But if your system is really big, it's very dangerous, because your database, like the data that you're reading in, could actually be so massive that you can't store it all in memory. So that's something you should consider. You should always favor allowing the database to do your filtering logic for you. But as I said, there are a few exceptions that I've found. I don't know if these are necessarily valid reasons, but I do see them. The first reason is a time constraint. And that's something I think that software developers kind of, at least when you're coming to this code as a third party or as the next person, and you look at something somebody else wrote, when you see something that is a little bit weird, or you see that this is kind of, why are we doing it this way? Usually there is there's usually a good reason for it. So let's say, like, I've seen it many times where you read in like an entire collection of data, and then you do the filtering logic in memory, or you do something like that. And usually why that happens is because, like, when you ask the person about it, it'll give you the answer that, yeah, I was kind of stressed. I needed to ship it the same day. And since the query was a little bit more sophisticated than your average simple query, I did it that way. And although this is not the best reason in the world, it is a valid reason. If you have a time constraint, there's not much you can do. You have to ship it when you have to ship it, and then you have to cut some corners in order to fix it. That always, like, not always, but sometimes that comes back and bites you in the ass when your collection starts to grow, right? So that's not, it's not something you should do, but it is a reason. The second thing I see is that people do it when the database becomes a bottleneck. Now, once your system grows to a certain size, you will realize that it will slow down sometimes, and it will slow down because the database is, it's going to need the time it needs in order to do its job. It's very hard for you to scale up databases. It's much easier to scale up an application, but it's much trickier to scale up a database. And that's a very tricky situation to be in. Like, I would say that It's the... I honestly think that's one of the trickiest things in software development, like when you're managing really large scale systems. Because if you ever get to a point where your application is so popular or it gets so much so many queries from external sources that you can scale, like you can't really keep up, that's when you need to get really fancy with architecture and start thinking about slicing out data sets and maybe do caching. Like that's when it gets really tricky, guys. But that's also one of the reasons why some people will say that, yeah, if let's like you can actually start pulling out data, like you can create a simpler query and simply do the filtering in memory, because they will make the argument that it's easier to scale up your application servers than it is to scale up your database. And that is also true to a point. There are other strategies to do this, but I think that it's sort of true. I've seen situations where this is actually where what had to happen, because to put it simply, there was no other way to solve the performance issue. But you shouldn't do it unless you have that situation, unless you see that your database can simply not keep up with the amount of traffic you're receiving. Don't do that. Third and lastly, which I think is an interesting situation, is when you have a very, very advanced database query. What do I mean by that? Well, I mean that some queries are very, very complicated. It's some of the more advanced database queries I've seen are usually like people will create an entire massive SQL file with a bunch of really complicated joins and so forth and so forth. And the problem with this I see is that it becomes a little bit hard to maintain that over time and test it and make sure that it's working correctly. Now you can of course do this, like in theory you could create an integration test that simply reads in this file and creates like a fake data set in a database and then runs the query and gets what it's expecting. But I can also say that if you can, it's actually not a bad idea to slice up like a really big complicated query into a piece of logic instead and do maybe multiple database calls and do the filtering in memory, because usually in my experience, depending on how complicated the query is, it's actually easier for you to reason about and maintain logic, like software, like code that does this, as opposed to a very big SQL file. I mean, I've seen some queries that are fairly complicated. Like in Neo4j, for example, when you do relational type of things and you want to generate a bunch of statistics, like complicated statistics, that can get really, really messy. And honestly, sometimes I kind of go, and I've seen people do this, I kind of go, maybe it's better to do this as a batch job type of thing. Like you shouldn't do this ideally if you're forced to do it all the time. But statistics, like guys, you should know that generating statistics for your system can be a very, very heavy and complicated operation to do. And it's absolutely not something you should do during prime time on your application. You should absolutely never, like ideally, you should never like query your production database to get a bunch of statistics about your system. Because as I said, like usually you have to like go through all the records and like search through so much stuff that it puts a lot of stress on the database. But I raise my finger and I say, at small scales, guys, for the juniors, if you're not maintaining a really, really large system, you don't have to worry about this. It becomes an issue once you have a system that is used by quite a few people. I would say that on average, you're going to have a system where you have at least tens of thousands, if not hundreds of thousands of users every month. That's where you start to have to consider these sorts of things. So those are my thoughts on database querying. So what to take away from this? Favor always, if you can keep the query in the database, do that. But make exceptions when you start seeing that either your logic, like the database query, is really complicated, or if you see that the database can simply not keep up with all the queries you're receiving anymore. Have a great day.